A Napa guy knows the only way you'd give a freshly minted driver a brand new car is if he promises to never drive it. Instead, let him grind the gears and knock over the neighbor's mailbox in something a little more suited to his skill level. And with over 400,000 parts and a little Napa know-how, he can safely drive something that's nearly as old as he is. It's not perfect, but it's perfect for him. That's Napa know-how.
Blog Talk Radio.
Well, good evening, folks, and thank you for tuning in with me once again to another edition of True Conservative Radio. And of course, I am your host, the man they call Ghost. And once again, folks, I want to thank you very much for tuning in with me. I know that it's been some time since I conducted a broadcast here on the Blog Talk Radio Network, and it is episode number 176 for all the folks keeping track. But to be completely honest with you, folks, the reason that I haven't done these broadcasts on a frequent basis is because just take a look at what is going on here today in America. I mean, it's very hard to conjure up the energy and the inspiration to continue to do these goddamn broadcasts because, I mean, every time I turn on the boob tube, you see nothing but American stupidity and political complacency and lack of economic, political, and social direction. You see a lot of, I don't even know what to say. I can't even conjure up the words. I can't even describe it out here. But before I get all out of hand, that's the reasoning behind my absence as of late. So for all you folks keeping track of the program and want to be here with me live, if you happen to be listening to me through the podcast, follow me on your Twitter. The Twitter name to follow is Ghost Politics, all one word, no underscores, Ghost Politics. And you will be the first one notified when I conduct one of these sporadic live broadcasts. And, of course, folks, 176 is the episode. And there's a lot of things to go over. I mean, when I was, you know, trying to make up a little description for this program, I didn't even know where to start because there were so many things to talk about. But let's go ahead and talk about what happened this past, June 8th. On the Tuesday primaries. I mean, it was a woman's sweep, folks. Isn't that great? You had, what was it, Fiona Broad? I mean, I don't even know whether the Hewlett-Packard, you know, that woman who won the primary of some Senate seat in California. She's supposed to be the competition to Barbara Boxer. You've got Meg eBay Whitman, I believe running for the governor out there in California also, who won the primary as the front runner to run against the Democratic opponent. And then, of course, you had this peculiar situation out there in Nevada. And for you folks that aren't familiar with who in the hell is going to run against Harry Scary Reid, I strongly advise you to look up old Sharon Angle. That's right. Sharon Angle has actually won the nomination to run against Harry Scary Reid. And let me tell you something, folks. I'm surprised that I wasn't aware of this particular representative. But once again, folks, I mean, that's our mainstream media trying to suppress any candidates that are not of the status quo, so to speak. But Sharon Angle, to be completely honest with you, she sounds like she's been listening to the True Conservative broadcast and basically used most of the views expressed on this broadcast as the foundation of her policy. You know, and let me tell you, I want to take a little bit of time here to let everybody know who Sharon Angle is, because the Democrats believe that she's easier to beat because she's so, outlaw and, so much going rogue or whatever they're trying to categorize Sharon Angle as. But let me tell you, this is a true American patriot. I mean, you know, she has, according from her record here, has went against certain things that have been put forth in the Nevada Assembly because it was against constitutional law. You know, she is a staunch supporter of the Constitution, against taxes. I mean, she believes that the Department of Education should be completely eliminated. You know, and that's something that I've been promoting for a long period of time. I mean, eliminate the sons of bitches. It'll be a great day in American history when we see these teachers out there in the unemployment line, out there with their hands out. You know, it'll be a great day. I mean, they have to go out there and be accountable in the privatized education system that will be around in place of the abolishment of the public education system, because it needs to be abolished. It's a drain on the American tax system, and anybody who wants to debate that it isn't, you don't know your ass from your elbow. But once again, Sharon Angle running against Harry Scary Reid, and let me tell you, that man needs to be unelected. What a power-hungry, bureaucratic worm that moron is. Do you understand, folks, that this liberal regime has complete and total control of this government, and yet they can't get anything done? I mean, I don't know how much I need to overemphasize that with people. They have total control of this government. There should be no reason why Obama, with his mantras during the 2008 election campaigns, with his mantras of hope, with his mantra of change, and this illusion that people were going to get their mortgages eliminated, and there was going to be a damn Cadillac in every driveway. There was going to be, you know, food for everyone, whatever they had envisioned, okay? There should be no reason that that vision shouldn't have been implemented, given the fact that this liberal regime had complete, and had, it still has, what am I talking about? They still have complete and total control of this government, but why haven't they got anything done? These liberal bureaucrats, you ass clowns. I mean, you know, Harry Scary Reid doesn't agree with Plastic Face Pelosi. Plastic Face Pelosi doesn't agree with Junkyard America President Obama. You know, President Obama doesn't agree with both those. I mean, it's just stupid. It's a bureaucratic pissing contest. Meanwhile, the American public are being flushed down the toilet. Our tax dollars are being used to recapitalize Wall Street. Can you believe this crap? To merge the manufacturing of cars with the government. To federally mandate health insurance. This is what our tax dollars are being wasted on. And this is why I continue to do these broadcasts, and I hope, by God, do I hope that there's a couple of morons that are having synapses sparked in their simplistic lack of cognitive reasoning brains out there that are starting to realize that if you're going to pay taxes, and if you're going to go out there and believe in the capitalist system, because by God, I'm a capitalist until the day my heart stops beating. And if you're going to work for this capitalist system, you have to understand that we have bureaucrats in power today that have gone completely just overzealous, totalitarian. I mean, I don't even know what to describe it. And they have taken a dirty yellow bubbly piss on the taxpayer, and we need to stop it, and we need to stop it now. Because once there's no more taxpayers, how is this mechanism of government going to continue to go? I mean, can somebody explain that one to me? How is this mechanism of government going to continue to keep going if there is no taxpayer? What, are we just going to all accept the dictatorship of the proletariat? Is that what people are thinking? I mean, it's just stupid. But anyway, it's a breath of fresh air when I hear a candidate like Sharon Angle out there in Nevada taking on Harry Scary Reid. And let me tell you, I know that his disgusting, despicable political strategists are mounting up a sleazeball campaign against Sharon Angle because of her threat, to the bureaucratic establishment currently in power, and that's the liberal regime. I mean, let's talk about a little bit more about Sharon Angle. She doesn't believe that the United States should have anything to do with the United Nations. Sounds a lot like Ghost over here. I mean, you understand? I mean, this is right out of the True Conservative Radio program. All right? I mean, her health care policy, she wants to phase out Medicare and Social Security, move towards privatization. You know? I mean, you know, I've talked a little bit about, you know, fluoride in drinking water, and everybody thinks that that's not a big deal. She voted against it. I mean, this is a woman who obviously has been, you know, if she hasn't been listening to the True Conservative Radio program, she's been receiving it telepathically or in her dreams or something of that nature, because this is a breath of fresh air here. These are the kind of candidates that we need, damn it. She didn't believe in global warming. I don't believe in global warming, all right? And you can look back in the archive. I was the first one on here saying that these damn scientists out here that are claiming global warming were doing nothing but scamming the grant systems of their governments of origin just so that they can continue to get funding for some, you know, made-up garbage, which was what global warming was. It was ridiculous. Let me tell you something. I mean, she believes in the Second Amendment, and I'm a strong believer of the Second Amendment. I live out here in Texas where you can legally carry a concealed firearm, and I think that everybody should practice their constitutionally protected Second Amendment right, because there's a lot of these liberal bureaucrats that want to start rounding up, you know, getting firearms out of taxpaying citizens' hands, and I think that's a disgrace to this country's founding. I mean, you know, why and how do you think that by outlawing guns is going to save any kind of social fabric of this country? I mean, if you outlaw the guns, the only people that are going to have guns are the outlaws, you asshole. But, of course, the liberals don't want to talk about that. They want to have Rosie O'Donnell, you know, with her butchy haircut, you know, get in front of her little stupid daytime TV trying to corner, you know, Tom Selleck while he's trying to promote some stupid schmoz program, you know, talk about, oh, you know, don't you think that guns kill people? It's so bad. Shut up, you fat pig. But anyway, this, what we're talking about, folks, for all you folks that are just tuning in, we're talking about what happened this past Tuesday, June 8, 2010. We're talking about the women's sweep in the primaries. We're talking a little bit about Sharon Angle and how those of us that are of the conservative or true conservative persuasion and don't agree with what's going on here in the political spectrum, both on the right and the left, should take a little bit of what Sharon Angle has put forth as her platform, which is a lot of what has been said on this program the entire time it's been on. So we need more candidates like this, and if we're not going to have more candidates like this, we just need more candidates that have nothing to do with the Republican Party or the Democratic Party or any other party that's being funded by these weasels that want to continue this corporate socialist ridiculous mechanism of government and mode of production that we have currently. And by God, I don't want to have nothing to do with it. That's why I continue to do these broadcasts. Anyway, I want to talk about this Meg Whitman over here. And the only reason I want to talk a little bit about Meg Whitman is because, you know, here's a woman that's already spent over $80 million of her own dollars into a political campaign. And I don't understand. I mean, for what? For what exactly? I mean, she wants to take over a state that is pretty much economically insolvent. They've been so fiscally irresponsible because they wanted this to play this "we are the world" leftist hippie, you know, pink team liberal crap for so long that it made them bankrupt. I mean, you know, California's one of the biggest economies in the world, and it went bankrupt. $80 million. Now, I have a problem with this. And the reason I have a problem with this is because why in the blue hell are you spending so much money to get a bureaucratic position? Now, I'm not saying anything. I just don't like it. And secondly, Meg Whitman, if you're going to spend $80 million to try to get a political seat, don't you think that you could have used about $5 million of those dollars to get a new haircut? I mean, good God, the sheepdog hairdo that she has is just pathetically disgusting. I mean, good Lord, I hate to be a Californian right now, sitting there in the boob tube trying to, you know, watch the ball game that sucked tonight. And, you know, you're going to watch a Meg Whitman commercial with that disgusting shemp from Three Stooges haircut that she's got saying, "Hi, I'm Meg Whitman, and I want to buy your vote." $80 million she's spending on this campaign, and she can't take a couple of million of it to, you know, cut that ridiculous mop she's got on that noggin. Good Lord. But anyway, and then we've got the Hewlett-Packard woman, you know, trying to, you know, run against Barbara Boxer. And to be completely honest, I don't think that she has much of a chance because, you know, in Barbara Boxer's district, it's just so liberal. It's so disgustingly liberal. It's not even liberal in the sense of, you know, schmucks that don't know what they're talking about. I mean, this is liberal elitist at its finest in that district. So I think she's facing staunch competition with Barbara Boxer, but I definitely want to support Sharon Angle out there for running against Harry Scary Reid. We need to unelect that piece of crap before he does any more damage. Him and the liberal regime do any more damage to this country. Anyway, folks, I want to hear from you. 646-652-4869 is the number to call here. We are talking about right now the Tuesday's primaries. That was a woman's sweep this past June 8, 2010. Now we're going to go ahead and switch gears here because I want to talk a little bit about what's going on in China right now, because I've been keeping those that have been listening abreast about the mass suicides that are happening in these manufacturing plants of a lot of our favorite electronic gadgets like iPads and iPhones. We've got a lot of people distressed about being overworked, so to speak. I mean, I was reading a New York Times article that said that one of these schmucks that decided to give themselves a dirt nap actually had worked, you know, 250 hours or some crap 1 month, and only got a whopping, what, $3 and change for all that hard labor for the proletariat of Mao Zedong's communist government. Yeah, I mean, it's a disgrace. Well, finally, the Chinese people have just had about enough of it. It's the youth of China that's finally starting to stand up and say that they don't want to have anything to do with being exploited for slave labor. And the reason is because the media, you know, as much as the Chinese government has attempted to suppress the media out there, the internet is it's a great thing. I mean, it was able to penetrate the forces of those censors out there in China, and they've been able to understand what exactly is transpiring within their borders, even though that everything is state-run. They understand now that they are being exploited. They're being exploited by a communist government that is teaching them that they have to be workers for the proletariat. You know what I'm talking about, that whole, you know, the peasant is the purest form of humanity, Mao Zedong crap. You know what I'm talking about. And they're starting to realize that all these assholes in the communist government of China are becoming billionaires off of their sweat equity that they're getting absolutely nothing for. They're getting peanuts. You know? Well, anyway, you actually are starting to see the beginning. I mean, it's small in remnants, but I believe that it's going to get a lot bigger than this. And thank God for that, because I have always said in this program that Tiananmen Square, I always said that Tiananmen will rise again. And those individuals that lost their lives back when those Tiananmen Square massacres were implemented by that ridiculous communist government, those people who died are not going to go in vain, because let me tell you, this all this hypocrisy that this government that supports this Mao Zedong ideology, the hypocrisy, the stench of it, has even gotten so overwhelming that a controlled population like the Chinese people are finally starting to rebel against it. And it's unbelievable. Recently, we've had strikes. Yeah. Actual labor strikes happening in China. Organized labor strikes. I wonder where they learned that from, Mao. I mean, they're having organized labor strikes, and the government just doesn't know what the hell to do about it. They're like, good, I don't know what to do. They don't know what to do about it. And let me tell you something. There's something they can do about it. You Mao Zedong worshiping pieces of peasant is the purest form of humanity crap. There's nothing you can do about it. And let me tell you, if there's anybody in China that's listening to my voice right now, keep organizing, because let me tell you, this communism that you've been indoctrinated in is just an absolute farce. It's a fake. You know, just take a look at your family lineage, Chinese people, and take a look at how many people died in the name of this ridiculous, secularist, dumbass, collective, centralized planning mode of production that Karl Marx and Mao Zedong call communism. Just take a look. And what has it done other than put you in not, I don't even want to call you slaves out there in China. I mean, you're below slaves. I would put you in the category of serf or even if there's any other category below that. Because what's unfortunate is that, you know, you individuals are out there, you know, getting the crumbs of whatever type of makeshift capitalist system that they're making for you out there in China. Meanwhile, the communist government, these bureaucrats that had no skill, that they had no economic prowess, they had nothing other than how to kiss a good ass within a political bureaucratic system, now they're becoming billionaires. They're becoming billionaires on the backs of these poor people in China. And now the Chinese government doesn't know what the hell they're going to do about it. I mean, you know it's a problem when a recent labor strike, an organized labor strike, happened at one of the Honda plants that's out there in China. I think that Honda, you know, manufactures a couple of things out there in a couple of factories. Well, this organized strike actually halted the production of the manufacturing out there in these Honda plants. And, you know, a lot of people are depending on this production. And because the Chinese people are deciding to utilize the Mao Zedong communist theory in their favor, the communist government of China is not really particularly happy about it. So you know it's trouble because the government of China has actually given in to some of these strikers. They've given in to the point where they've given these people raises in their pay. I mean, you know, the people at one Honda plant got up to 3 raises in the past month and a half, 3 different raises. And let me tell you, that's a recipe for disaster there, communist China, because once you give these people a little bit, they're going to want more. And they're going to want more, and they're going to keep wanting more, and they're going to want to ask questions, like why in the blue hell does this stupid bureaucrat have the ability to make billions of dollars when he didn't do anything to make it? I mean, all he was some bureaucrat that sat his fat ass in some chair somewhere and, you know, knew whose ass to kiss, and he got himself a decent bureaucratic position. Let me tell you, this organized labor strike in China is just utterly funny to me. Utterly funny. And I want to hear what you have to say about it. What do you think about the organized labor strikes in China that are halting production of many of the manufacturing widgets and products that we consume on a consistent and frequent basis? 646-652-4869 is the number to call. I want to hear from you. What do you think about this crap? 978, you're on the air.
Chocolate rain. Some stay dry and others feel the pain. Chocolate rain.
Yeah, it's a horrible rendition there, you stupid fruity milky liquor. 000, you're on the air.
Oh, it makes me horny, Gook. Oh, fuck yeah. Can I see your toolbox, Gook?
Get him off! I mean, you see what I'm saying out here? I mean, even the robotically trained Chinese people. I mean, you have to understand that China has been robotically trained by this mechanism of government that has put Mao Zedong in some sort of godhood. Even a robotically trained population like China knows when they're getting screwed. And here you have these idiots, you know, who have been listening to my broadcasts, who know the impending danger because I've been saying it, and everything that I have predicted that would come to pass has come to pass. These idiots are more worried about getting cracks from a couple of losers online, like that it's going to win brownie points with some sort of cyber poontang somewhere, and they're going to be able to do some sort of camera-to-camera session, and then they realize it's a 65-year-old prostate-infected man. This is America. This is America, folks. But once again, I want to extend my hand to China once again. Thank you for standing up to your bureaucratic government. The next thing you need to do is you need to wipe your dirty ass crack. After you had a good bowl of rice and a bad egg roll, you need to take a mad dump. You take one of the pictures that I'm sure you could find one anywhere of Mao Zedong, and you need to wipe your dirty ass with it. That's what you need to do. That's the next thing the Chinese people need to do. And I'm not kidding. I mean, you know, that's enough of Mao Zedong. That's enough of communism. We need to get rid of it. It's over. It's done. It's failed. I mean, you know, communism has been used to suppress a people into believing that they need to work like mules for the sake of, you know, I don't know, what, putting Mao Zedong into godhood? I don't understand. I never understood it. Don't care. But it's good to see the robotic people of China finally starting to come out of their damn eggshell, for heaven's sake. Anyway, I think we have somebody here from the communist government once again who actually wants to discuss a couple of things about this Chinese labor strike situation that they're having out there in China, because, of course, the Chinese government doesn't appreciate what I've been saying. So we have this official on the phone here from China. Mr. Fortune Cookie, are you there, sir?
Motherfucker out there talking garbage, ghost, about the communist government in China. Nothing's going on over here. We're taking care of problem. The labor strikes have nothing to do with the going to strike or off a line. So all you stupid motherfucker trying to make a bigger deal out of all this, you need to shove a chopstick up your asshole. Motherfucker! And all you Chinese people that aren't following orders from Chinese government, you better remember that you're doing it for Chairman Mao! Do it for Chairman Mao! That's right. You need to do it for Chairman Mao! Do it for Chairman Mao! I have nothing else to say. I am Mr. Fortune Cookie. Thank you very much.
All right, get him off. Just shut him up. But there you go. The communist government in China has no concern about the organized labor strikes that are halting production in their assembly lines throughout the country. And what I'm saying is that they need to start worrying, and they need to start worrying now, because if they're not going to start worrying, they're going to get bitch slapped into reality once that country goes under revolution. And by God, if the Chinese government falls under revolution, I wouldn't shed a tear for that Mao Zedong worshiping communist piece of crap. Do you understand that? I wouldn't shed a tear. One tear, one bit. I would charter a plane and throw bad egg rolls at the, you know, Chinese government when they're running for cover after the Chinese people finally get a hold of enough people to just run their asses out of the country. All right, and you can tell those Mao Zedong worshiping, that Hu Jintao, you can tell him I said that. 646-652-4869. 503, you're on the air.
Ghost.
What's going on?
I was born in Fullerton, California, and today is a great day for me because, first of all, to all the fans out in the Boston, Massachusetts area, to the Bill Russell fans, to Bill Russell when he called Wilt a quitter, Bill Russell can keep presenting the MVP championship, the trophy for the World Championship Series to Kobe Bryant every year, and I'm gonna love every minute of it. You know what, Ghost? I didn't call to talk politics because I'm on cloud nine right now. And I know that there's serious things happening out there in the global community. And I appreciate you coming on the air. I've been listening to the archive, and I went back in, like, February 2008, and there was 22 broadcasts, Ghost. Where have you been, my friend? And we need you. America needs you, and I hope you
– We need you, Ghost!
I hope you continue to come on the airwaves as many times as you can. And to all the Celtic fans out there in Boston, you can go guzzle clam chowder until you vomit in the toilet.
Champions, baby! I love it! Come on, ass, you Boston
Celtics! Y'all partying over there or what? Y'all partying?
I love the show, Ghost. I love the show, and I'm out of here.
All right. Thank you very much. And as you can see, they're partying over there in L.A. because, of course, the L.A. Lakers won the Game 7 title. Of course, for you folks that have kept track with the True Conservative Radio program, you know I don't really watch sporting events any longer because I believe that most sporting events are orchestrated by the organizations that have a financial incentive to see the more marketable team win Game 7 or a Finals or a Super Bowl or anything of that nature. But it's good to hear that there's a lot of energy going on out there in L.A. It sounds like there's a lot of boozing, you know, a lot of tipping back some cheap-ass bottles of hooch. But inevitably, there's a lot of people in L.A. happy right now. And, you know, they're so happy it sounded like Angelina Jolie promised them a hand job at the end of the night or something of that nature. I mean, good God. Good Lord. Anyway, 646-652-4869 is the number to call. We are having some technical difficulties once again with the broadcast. I can see that there's individuals that are in the chat room saying that they don't have sound. I mean, what can I tell you? The Blog Talk Radio Network, folks. All right, please forward any technical problems that you're having straight to them. Because they need to fix the problem, in my view. It was good to hear some people that, are not only hype about the Lakers winning the ball game or whatever, but they're hype about the True Conservative Radio program. Anyway, folks, what we're talking about is the labor revolt in China. We're talking about the halt in production of many of the products that we consume here in America because there is actual organized labor. I wonder where the Chinese people learned that. But these organized labor strikes that are actually halting production to a lot of these products, it's unbelievable. Unfreaking believable. I mean, give me a break. Anyway, folks, I want to say thank the Chinese people for finally waking up out of their robotic hypnotic state. I mean, you know that there's trouble. You know that there's trouble when you have the Chinese government bowing down and giving people raises. They gave people 3 raises in the past month and a half out at some Honda plant. So I tell you what, Mr. Fortune Cookie and all the communist government out there, your days are numbered, Hu Jintao. Your days are numbered, and it'll be a great day in world history to finally see another communist power bite the dust from inside out. You know, and I'm sure that there's people that are pissed off about me saying that, but, you know, gosh damn it, I remember Tiananmen Square. I remember when the communist government of China mowed down those people like dogs, and they didn't do anything but just domestic civil unrest. I mean, they were going on hunger strikes. You know, I mean, they massacred these people as if they were Che Guevara or Fidel Castro in the bush somewhere with a whole bunch of military assault rifles or something. I mean, they just massacred these children. And what the Tiananmen Square protesters were expecting is that when the communist government mowed them down like dogs and shot them and ran them over with tanks, they thought that the West would show compassion and come in and save the day, which, unfortunately, folks, we didn't. So I will always remember Tiananmen Square. I will never forget Tiananmen Square. I feel bad that nobody came to the aid of those that actually wanted to participate in not only democratic forms of government, but a capitalist form of mode of production. Long live Tiananmen Square. And I hope that these organized labor movements that they learn from Maoism, stupid idiots. I mean, you know, how did this communist government think that at some point the labor that they were extorting out of their people while they became billionaires being government bureaucrats, how did they not think that the people that were working for them weren't going to, I don't know, figure out how organized labor worked, considering that you had Mao Zedong preaching this communist red book crap? It's great. I love to see hypocrisy slapped in its face. Anyway, folks, you know, it's good to see some civil disorder out there in China, because that could get very ugly. You see how desperate the Chinese government is. They'll kill everybody if they want to, you know? Anyway, we're going to continue on. I'm going to talk a little bit about the international disorder. We've been talking about international disorder the whole time that we've been conducting these broadcasts. Another country is fallen under civil unrest. I mean, and this isn't just, you know, hunger strikes and, not going to sleep and crap. I mean, these people are killing people out here. And I'm talking about Kyrgyzstan. And for you folks that's not, you know, that are not keeping up to date with what's going on in Kyrgyzstan, well, for some reason, the Kyrgyzstanians decided that they wanted to go out and ethnically cleanse their country of anybody who is Uzbekistan or Uzbeki or Uzbeki. Sorry if I'm mispronouncing the ethnic name there, but a lot of these people are getting massacred and slaughtered out there. And, you know, what the hell do you do? I mean, this is just another episode in a whole domino effect that's happening throughout the international community, something that I have been talking about for the past 3 or 4 years I've been doing this broadcast, folks. I mean, this is a serious situation. I mean, you know, the whole reason why the international situation is unraveling is because those countries that are, you know, basically sitting on bad blood are looking at the international community and seeing such disorder. Henceforth, it justifies their direct confrontation or direct action on anything or anybody or any entity that they confront. I mean, you know, this is why you're seeing such horrific disorder. I mean, in Thailand, I mean, they recently squashed the unrest that was happening in Bangkok. They actually held a lot of those financial districts a captive, you know, the red shirts, which are, you know, basically peasants from the outskirts of the metropolises that are in Thailand. They came into these big economic epicenters and took it hostage and overran the Thailand Stock Exchange and did all this nonsense for what? I have no idea. I mean, they claimed that they wanted new elections, they wanted a new government, this and that, but they ended up destroying the city and getting nothing done. I mean, there's all kinds of, you know, freaked out things that are going to go on in Thailand. And speaking of that part of the world, the Philippines, another country that's going completely ballistic. All right, I mean, believe me, the government has suppressed many attempts at civil unrest out there in Philippines, and believe me, the government is a bureaucratic, corrupt hellhole. But within the past 24 hours in Philippines, there have been two radio DJs, you know, the equivalent of what I do or the equivalent of what some asshole like Glenn Beck or Mark Levin does, you know, these people that are outspoken critics of government and social and political economic events. Well, within the past 24 hours, two radio DJs have been killed because of their exposure and their controversial topics based around government corruption and its influence on the criminality of the whole country. And this is another threat, all right? This is yet another threat to anybody who's trying to bud as a country that not only embraces capitalism but democratic forms of government. This is just international disorder, you know, time and time again, folks. I don't know what else to say. What are we going to do, folks? I mean, you know, Kyrgyzstan is under disorder because they want to get rid of their country's Uzbeks. Thailand, you know, I know that's simmering down, but I believe that's going to, you know, come back to haunt us once again. You've got the Philippines, you know, conveniently killing journalists or individuals who are critical of their governments. You've got the communist uprising of all those, dumbass little rebel groups in South America. I'm out here in Texas, folks. I'm on the front lines out here witnessing what's happening here in the borders based upon these drug wars that are happening out here. The violence is coming in through the border. Recently, there was a grenade that was thrown into the American border from the Mexican border. I mean, it's getting pretty disgusting out here. I mean, can we continue going on? I mean, we got bad blood with India and Pakistan, you know? I mean, I just don't know what the hell else to say. It's just utterly disgusting and pathetic. But I want to hear from you, 646-652-4869. What do you think? We were talking a little bit about the labor revolt in China. We're talking also about Kyrgyzstan and its ethnic cleansing on the Uzbeks. Pretty sick situation happening out here in the international community, folks. I'm telling you, I don't understand why everybody can't just abide by civilization and understand that we should just be happy that we're not out hunting our food, that we're not out having to make our own clothes and build our own freaking houses and, you know, having to go out and figure out how we're going to, you know, conduct everyday life by ourselves. I mean, we've got the comforts, all right? We've got the comforts of modernity. And people want to sit here and piss and moan about it. It's a disgrace. Huh. I just don't know what to say, folks. 646-652-4869 is the number to call here. Once again, we're talking about labor revolt in China and disorder in Kyrgyzstan. 718, you're on the air.
Hi, Ghost. Where have you been? Oh, my God.
Jesus Christ. This idiot.
I love you. Ghost. Did you hang up on me, baby? Ghost.
I mean, is everybody hearing this?
Ghost, but remember that time you put your Texas cock in my ass? That was so good. Ghost,
get this idiot off! I mean, you see what I'm saying here? I'm talking about serious subject matters. These people are, you know, thinking about homosexual erotic activity. You know? And then we wonder how episodes of Chris Hansen to Catch a Predator became so prevalent and so easy to come by. I mean, listen to these sick perverts. You know, I mean, I wouldn't be surprised if that asshole's calling me from a cell phone of some glory hole in San Francisco right now. Because he's happy that, you know, his favorite ball player, Kobe Bryant, won the finals. So now he's at the local bathhouse looking to get done Kobe style. Give me a break. 646-652-4869. Like I said, we're talking about the labor revolt in China. Long live Tiananmen Square. And we're also talking about the disgusting civil unrest that's happening in Kyrgyzstan, which is the ethnic cleansing of the Uzbeks, which is a disgusting situation happening out there. Let's take a couple of anonymous callers, and hopefully some people have something to say. 111, you're on the air.
Hey, Ghost. I just want to touch on, you were talking about the gun control issue before.
Yeah.
Yeah. Look, I'm from Australia, and we don't really have guns available to the public. Now, an interesting case happened the other day. There was a guy called Charlie McGee in Sydney who actually went on a rampage, and he ended up hitting some people. He carjacked some cars, hit some people with a hammer. You can check this out on the internet. It's completely true. Now, he said he would have killed people if he had a gun. So what do you say to that?
Well, you know, what I say to that is that, and I want to thank you for your call. I know I have a lot of people listening to me in Australia. I get a lot of email from you guys out there, shrimp under the Barbie and all that crap. But what I say is that if there was somebody out there that was actually carrying a gun, a legal firearm, a taxpayer of the Australian people out there, if they were actually carrying a concealed handgun, they would have been able to pop a cap at this fool before he even decided to go out and, you know, start carjacking and going on some sort of criminal crime spree. You know, I mean, that kind of crap doesn't happen too often out here in Texas. You know, you go out and start robbing people or start carjacking people or start, you know, going on kind of some kind of rampage. There's going to be somebody with a legal firearm, and under Texas law, they're within their legal right to dispense your life with extreme prejudice. And thank God for that. So that's what I have to say to that, to the Australian feller that called up. You know, and you know what? He was a nut. If he didn't have a hammer, he would have used a bat. If he didn't have a bat, he would have used scissors. He would have used anything. I mean, when people are nuts, they're just nuts. You know, it's just all there is to it. I mean, what can I say to that? And his response was, if I had a gun, I would have killed people. I mean, great. I mean, you know, so what? I mean, the Australian people, you know, inevitably are at the mercy of the government. I mean, they actually believe that the government is going to protect them at all times. I mean, what if gangs of hordes of people decide to go on the countryside out there in Australia and start massacring people out there in the urban lands out there, and in the urban sprawl. I mean, you wouldn't be able to do anything. You'd be at the whim of the government. But out here in America, we can protect ourselves. We have the right to bear arms. You know, I mean, if there was ever any kind of civil disorder, I mean, if you at least appreciated your neighbor and wasn't an ass clown and decided to be, you know, Mr. I'm going to keep to myself, idiot. But if you were good with your neighbors and, you know, everybody in your street, if civil unrest happened, you should have an agreement with those individuals and say, hey, we're going to come together and watch our street, make sure we don't get infiltrated by the damn savages that are going to be out looting all over the damn street when civil unrest ever does happen. You know, I mean, there's just so many benefits of having, you know, an armed populace. I mean, if there was ever any invaders from another country, for instance, they wouldn't be able to overtake the country. Are you kidding me? Let's say China, which it's never going to happen, but let's say China decides to invade America and decides to throw Chinese troops on here. You think that the American people are just going to go willingly? You know, you think that the American people are just going to sit back and just, oh, yeah, okay, China. Yeah, no. They're going to fight back, and they're going to have the means to fight back. 646-652-4869. 479, you're on the air.
Ghost, I'm actually from Texas.
Oh, my God, are you kidding? How many damn phone numbers do you have? Good God, get them off. Anyway. 228, you're on the air.
Yeah, my name is Mickey, and I'm from Biloxi, Mississippi.
Hey, what's going on?
Look, I wanted to talk about the BP oil spill. I'm pissed off about the BP oil spill because it's ruining the community that I live in. BP, for years, has been developing technology known as MBT rods to help them stop these deep water oil leaks, and they have yet to utilize the MBT rods.
Okay.
All right, so why doesn't BP use these nigger bitch titty rods to plug the oil spill? I don't understand.
You know what? You should call Tony Hayward and ask him. And speaking of which, let's go ahead and segue to that other subject matter. I want to talk a little bit about not only the BP oil spill and Tony Hayward's testimony today, but I want to talk a little bit about Obama kicking ass. That's right. I want to talk a little bit about Obama kicking some ass out here, because in a recent interview with, the adulterous Matt Lauer, Obama decided to, I guess, get ghetto. You know, and how quaint that, I mean, you know, this idiot Obama is throwing race relations back about 150 years with his incompetence. It's just completely disgusting. I mean, this guy thinks now he's you know, Ice Cube from Boys in the Hood or something. This was his response when his, you know, to critics like myself who, you know, didn't like his response to the BP oil spill. Go ahead and roll it.
I was down there a month ago, before most of these talking heads were even paying attention to the Gulf. A month ago, I was meeting with fishermen down there, standing in the rain, talking about what a potential crisis this could be.
Yeah.
And I don't sit around just talking to experts because this is a college seminar. We talk to these folks because they potentially have the best answers, so I know who's ass to kick.
So I know who's ass to kick, huh? Isn't that great? Yeah, you know, he's talking to experts, so he knows who's ass to kick. I mean, is Obama really kicking ass out here? It looks more like he's kissing ass. Now, let me explain why I am in such opposition to what's going on down here in the Gulf. Now, I know that there's a lot of assholes that are still trying to, I don't know, justify BP, British Petroleum's role, and are trying to give them the benefit of the doubt when it comes to this so-called capping of this oil leak. But, you know, folks, they're not going to – capping this, it's not going to happen. BP is not capping this. You can look at the damn footage that they're supplying themselves. They are not capping it. What are they doing? They're putting mechanisms around it so that they can suck up the oil so they can sell it on the world market, you know? When the prices of oil goes through the roof here at the midsummer, coming around July 4th. Yeah, they're not capping this crap. They're not trying to stop the leak. This is an ecological disaster. And you have our president and the liberal regime that's in complete and total control of this government sitting on their thumbs. You've got the media, the freaking media, not giving us the whole truth about what the hell's going on out there. I mean, the media is basically playing us hook, line, and sinker and trying to downplay this whole devastation. I mean, I remember 24-hour footage with Katrina. I mean, I remember this type of intense investigative reporting on other subject matters. But here, in one of the biggest ecological disasters in the world, the media is just giving us little tidbits and giving us little sound bites. I see the same damn clip over and over and over again whenever they talk about this stupid damn oil spill in the Gulf. It's a disaster! I mean, what has happened out here in the Gulf should be the equivalent of terrorism! It should be the equivalent of terrorism! It should be the equivalent of terrorism! I mean, don't you idiots realize that not only is ecology being destroyed, but many of our natural resources are being destroyed? You know that businesses that have been out in the Gulf that fish crawfish and shrimp and all the specialties of the Gulf are going out of business? These are businesses that have been there for 150 years! and they're going out of business because they're never going to be able, or at least not in their lifetime, in my opinion, they're not going to be able to fish those seas any longer because they've been polluted. And Obama's kicking ass out here. How is Obama kicking ass, huh? I mean, he got ghetto about it and say, yeah, baby, I talk to them people because I figure out what ass I'm going to kick, baby. I mean, this is just a disgrace. That's another reason why I haven't been up here very often, folks. I've been out there at my beachfront property in Padre Island out there, soaking up the last bit of clean sea out there, and it ain't very clean, let me tell you that. But let me tell you, I'd hate to be in Mississippi, I'd hate to be in Louisiana, I'd hate to be in these Gulf regions that are seeing dead porpoises with, oily discharges of black tea coming out of their blowholes, dead tortoises. I'd hate to be seeing this crap. I'd rather see dead people. I'd rather see dead people than see dead dolphins and porpoises. It's a disgrace. And you know what? I mean, you know, what is our government doing? We're taking care of it. Look, and then you see what happened today, all right? What happened today was a disgrace. You know, Obama thinks that he solved the problem. He solved the problem because he was able to get a commitment of a $20 billion. So everything should be okay now, huh? That's right. Obama today, you know, while they were, grilling Tony Hayward, the president of British Petroleum, they decided that they were going to go ahead and, try to make things better by saying, hey, look, they agreed to give us $20 billion in an escrow account so that anybody who, withstood any damages can get some money off it. And you know what's happening to all the people that are out there without a job in the Gulf? Huh? They're going to the unemployment insurance. They're going to the welfare line because there's no jobs anymore. And you want to know, before I make any more crack comments about Tony Hayward, this is a true conservative radio exclusive, okay? We actually have Tony Hayward on the line here, ready to give a couple of statements on behalf of British Petroleum. Now, don't tell me how we were able to get Tony Hayward on there. I don't want to, Ghost has got his connections. You know, he's connected in here. We actually have Tony Hayward on the line, basically stipulating, I don't know what the hell he's going to say. Tony Hayward, are you there, sir? Are you there? I guess that's him. Hey, hold on. Hey, shut up. Hey, Tony. Hey, can you turn down, your radio or whatever the hell, your intro music or whatever the hell you call it? Tony Hayward, can we get you on again here, please? What the hell is this anyway? All right, here's Tony Hayward, folks. Oh, yes. I'm Tony Hayward, and I want to let everybody know out there the whole reason why British Petroleum is not, doing our best to dislodge the leak in the Gulf is because we want to destroy. We want to destroy the Gulf. We don't want you to sell any more fish. We want you to buy our fish and chips. That's why we're doing it, yes? We want you to buy our fish and chips. That's what we want you to do. And you see, we're not going to plug the hole. No, we're not going to plug the hole because we want you to buy our fish and chips. And we want you to pay top dollar. And we're not going to fix it, you stupid Yanks. We're not going to do it. All right? I'm Tony Hayward. And you people need to understand, I want my life back. Do you understand? I want my life. I'm out here, you know, working about 24 hours a day, mate. I want my life back. Anyway, you stupid Yanks, you're not going to get. You're not going to see the Gulf. We're just collecting all the oil that's coming out the leak, and you're not going to see any more Gulf, mate. We don't want you to sell fish on the international market no more. You have to buy our fish and chips now. You have to buy our fish and chips because we are the best the UK has to offer. Anyway, I haven't had much sleep. Ghost, you can take me off now. I have nothing else to say to these peasants. All right, shut him off. Get him off! But as you can see from Tony Hayward, I mean, you heard it directly from the horse's mouth, the whole reason why British Petroleum is not plugging the leak or not attempting to stop the leak or not attempting to, you know, halt the ecological devastation, frankly, is because the English, you know, have a vested interest in seeing our natural resources of seafood in the Gulf limited in traumatic fashion. You know, don't you think that, you know, those individuals that are around coastal regions that aren't afflicted by the Gulf BP oil spill, you don't think that these individuals are going to, or these countries, I should say, have, you know, a vested interest in seeing the ecological natural resources of fishery and other seafood out here in America just be completely obliterated? I mean, of course they would. You know, and Tony Hayward said it himself. I mean, you know, you're talking about the pure epitome of evil. I mean, you couldn't have gotten a better Satanist-looking guy. You know, some heartless bastard, Tony Hayward, you know. I tell you, you Brits, you need to lay off the damn, you know, tea and, you know, stop eating all that fried fish and chips. It's getting to your head. It's clouding your judgment. But once again, this is Obama kicking ass, right? Obama's kicking some ass out here, isn't he? Here, 646-652-4869. Let's see if people think that Obama's kicking ass. Hey, 631, you there?
Yeah, what up, man? It's your man Tyrone over here. Yo, what you got?
Hey, here we got Tyrone going on over here. Hey, what do you think about Tony Hayward and all the and Obama?
Yo, Obama's the man up in this bitch, you know what I'm saying, man? Yo, he's helping the brother out over here, you know? He came out for my Cadillac, for my kids, and for my women, dude.
He's paying for your Cadillac and your women?
The women? Yeah, homie, what up?
You know, oh, yeah, you got the housing voucher program going on over there?
Yeah, I hope you know you pay for that, right? You pay for that. You pay your taxes, so you, I get them. I get your taxes, homie.
Get this here. Get him off! I mean, but seriously, folks, I mean, you know, I don't know if that guy's being facetious. He always calls every time. But let me tell you, these people need to just get, you know, let me calm down, folks. You know, the Lakers won the finals, didn't they? It was a game 7, isn't it? Well, I don't necessarily want to celebrate the Lakers, all right? What I got here is I got a bottle of Don P., all right? That's right, and for you folks that, you know, don't have any kind of class whatsoever, Don P. is Dom Perignon, folks. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to break open this Don P. before I start going completely ballistic and possibly hurting myself in the process. Because I can't believe that America is not only sitting on their fat jelly asses watching their country be destroyed by a bunch of bureaucrats that have taken complete and total power of this government, but they've accepted, the dissolution of America being any kind of a superpower. I mean, because the rate we're going third world status, folks. We're going to be a technocratic third world nation, and we should be ashamed of ourselves that, you know, we deserve better than this. Being such, an industrious nation, such a nation that was supposed to be the epitome of capitalism, we have now become the bastards of capitalism. So let me go ahead and get this Dom Perignon uncorked here for you folks. So I'm just going to drink it out of the bottle. I'm drinking the whole damn bottle anyway. I don't really give a crap. And if I happen to get a little tipsy on here, well, you know what? Tough titty. Tough titty. I mean, I got a lot to think about out here. I mean, it hurts to wake up every morning, you stupid Milky Lickers. So here, let me go ahead and pop this bottle. And before I pop this bottle goes to the American taxpayer and the American youth. To the American taxpayer and the American youth, this bottle goes out to you. Let me go ahead and pop this bottle here. Here we go. There we go. Popping bottles out here. Popping a bottle of Dom P, and we're drinking it straight out of the bottle like Birdman and all those fools from the rap industry who try to influence our youth into becoming degenerate losers. I'm drinking it straight out of the bottle so I can be hip, so that children can relate to me, so they can say, hey, look, he's sipping Dom P straight out of the bottle like Lil Wayne. Oh, he really relates to me. Well, you know what? I mean, you know, what you need to understand is that the things that I have said on this broadcast, the things that I have predicted have come to pass. So anyway, I'm going to take this first sip of Dom P. Ah. Oh, yeah. That's what I'm talking about. That's what I'm talking about. Nothing like uncorking some Dom P and drinking it straight out of the bottle. That's capitalism for you, folks. And let me tell you, I've got some Opus X Arturo Fuente cigars right here, which go for about $50 a stick, you know, especially those Special Reserve Opus X cigars. And I would be sparking one up while I'm drinking this Dom P, but, you know, the missus doesn't like me smoking in the house. So, unfortunately, I can't do that. But I just want you to know that on top of sipping this Dom P, that's exactly what I'd be doing. Because, you don't want to know why I'm indulging, folks? Because we're not going to be able to indulge that much longer, all right? We're not going to be able to indulge that much longer. Because there's no economic opportunity. I mean, look at the bad numbers that are coming out as each month goes by. We have yet to see the wave of fluctuating rate mortgages that have yet to become default. And those things are coming this summer, folks. Anyway, folks, 646-652-4869 is the number to call. I know I'm getting off keister here. We're supposed to be talking about the BP oil spill, how it's such an ecological disaster, it should be compared to terrorism. And unfortunately, nobody gives a crap. Everybody's trying to give everybody excuses. You got the left-wing liberal hippies that are out here trying to give excuses to the president, trying to give excuses to the liberal regime, trying to give excuses to everything. So I want to hear from you, 646-652-4869. What do you think about the BP oil spill and Satan himself, Tony Hayward, and his ridiculous testimony and that half-ass apology that he gave the American people? 1111, you're on the air.
Hello?
Yeah, what's going on? Yeah, what's going on?
Hey, I think this oil spill is ridiculous because I recently just got my pilot's license, and every time I go fly over the Gulf and I try to do barrel rolls and shit, I fucking can't breathe at all.
Jesus Christ. You see, that almost worked. You almost got points for that. But then you had to curse, like, you're coming straight out of Compton when I know your sorry ass is coming out of some trailer park somewhere. You almost got some lulls there, you Milky Licker. Next time, trying to sound a little bit more legitimate instead of sounding like some ass clown that hopped out of the anal passage of Eminem. All right there, you cracker-ass cracker. All right, 1111, you're on the air.
Gosh, that annoying gay guy that keeps calling you, I just wanted to say to him, particularly to him, you leave Ghost alone, you bitch, because he's mine. I want to take that Dom Perignon bottle and shove it up your ass.
Oh, Jesus Christ. I mean, this is what I'm saying, I mean, I got fans and internet butt stalkers all over the world. Give me a break. Why don't you, people that are throwing all this homosexual innuendo in these prank calls, why don't you take about 10 steps away from my freaking butt crack, all right? Why don't you just take about 10 steps away, back away, all right? It's exit only, ass clowns, all right? Good God. I bet you these idiots thought, I bet you they think, oh, yeah, I would love to get Ghost in prison. Oh, yeah, he wouldn't be able to run from me in prison, huh? Oh, yeah, well, you know what, I tell you what, even if there was a gang of you idiots and you thought that you can, you know, give me some sort of a little homoerotic garbage, I won't clean my ass. How you like that, huh? I'll have a dirty, bacon-bit-ridden anal passage that y'all can have at it, all right? It'll smell like, you know, disgusting, you know, rotten eggs with, you know, mixed with rotten meat and, you know, who the hell knows what else. You stupid fruity asses. 725, you're on the air.
Hello?
Yeah, what's going on?
Hey, Ghost, I'm a big fan of you right here. This is Rob from, you know, from Spain.
Yo, what's going on?
Yeah, man, I listen to your show every day, and I'm tired of these people that call you up and throw this barrel of dumb shit at you, man. I mean, you're trying to put points here, man, about how they're getting fucked. Now, I actually don't live in the States anymore. You know, I moved back to Spain, but yeah, they don't listen, you know?
No, they don't listen, you know, and I thank you for calling. They don't listen. You know, I wonder what the hell people are doing right now whenever they listen to me, you know, try to discuss this conservative commentary. I mean, what are these people doing? What are they playing with their pecker shafts? I mean, am I like background music while these morons are trying to look for Little Miss Annie Mae Rottencrotch to finger bang on the internet? I mean, am I like the background noise for I don't know. I mean, you know, internet surfing sessions? I don't get it. I don't understand. I mean, somebody please call me and help me. Is this thing on? You know, give me a call. Let me know what's going on. 646-652-4869. We were talking a little bit about Tony Hayward and the BP oil spill and how, you know, it's such ecological devastation to the natural resources of America that it should be equivalent to terrorism, and yet our government is just sitting by on their thumbs allowing British Petroleum, this foreign entity, to have way with our natural ecological system. And we just heard Tony Hayward on the horn here saying that, you know, the whole reason why BP is, you know, just sitting on their ass not capping the leak is because they want to be able to destroy our ecological system so America will have to buy their fish and chips. Great. Let me take some more chugs out of this bottle here. Oh. Whoo, man, that is smooth. That is smooth. What year is this? It's an 04. Yeah, 04. 04 Dom P. You know, it's going down pretty smooth, folks. Hopefully that you're doing some adult activities that aren't related to anything sexual, and hopefully you're having a drink, smoking a stove, or chilling with me right now. 646-652-4869. We began the program talking about the women who swept the June 8 Tuesday primaries. We talked about how Meg Whitman and her use of her wealth, using $80 million of her own money to influence the electorate in the state of California to vote for her, is just utterly ridiculous and fishy. And what I said is that if Meg Whitman can spend $80 million to buy airtime and to buy people's vote, do you think that she could have at least, you know, set aside $10 million of that to get a new freaking hairdo? I mean, has anybody seen the sheepdog hairdo that this broad got? I mean, she looks like Shaggy, for heaven's sake. You know what I'm talking about? She looks like Shemp from the Three Stooges, for heaven's sake. I mean, $80 million of her own money spent thus far on this campaign, and she can't get a decent hairstylist? I mean, what kind of confidence does that say to me? What does that say to me as a voter there, Meg Whitman? You want to spend $80 million to shove your ugly grill in my face every 5 minutes on a damn advertisement, and yet you can't even fix your freaking hair? I mean, where are your priorities, you ditzy bimbo? And anyway, we went on to talk about how there's labor revolts in China, there's civil disorder in Kyrgyzstan, ethnic cleansing in Kyrgyzstan of the Uzbeks, which is a serious situation. And now we have talked about how Obama was, instead of kicking ass, he was kissing ass. And this BP oil situation, it's utterly disgusting. I want to hear what you have to say about it. 646-652-4869 is the number to call here. 645, you there?
Hi, Ghost.
What's going on?
Oh, me, Ghost. Is it the Ralph or Neil? You're a call. How you doing, Ghost?
No, I'm all right. What's going on, man?
I actually want to talk about Howard Stern's penis in your asshole.
Oh, Jesus Christ. And then Howard Stern again, huh? Howard freaking Stern. Why are people doing prank calls in the name of Howard Stern? Can somebody answer me that? And let alone referring to Howard Stern's penis. I mean, do you understand this man's an old gas bag? I mean, do you understand that, right? I mean, this is not some young, cool guy that's, you know, able to get it up every time he needs to, you know, put it in some young woman's hole. I mean, do you understand that Howard Stern cannot get it up, you stupid ass clown? He's an old piece of crap, all right? I mean, you do understand that he has to take Viagra to, you know, attempt to have any kind of sexual relations. I mean, he's old. And why young people are following this moron is beyond me. It just goes to show you our warped media system. Our warped American media system, for heaven's sake. It's pathetic. It's pathetic. I mean, you know, some prostate-infected, old, big-nosed, ugly, wrinkled face. I mean, he looks like he just got taken out of the rain. I mean, this bastard, you got people worshiping him, and, you know, you got his followers calling me, making references to his genitals, for heaven's sake. Let me take a drink of this damn Dom P before I really get pissed off here. All right? And for you folks that aren't listening in, I just popped a bottle of 2004 Dom P here. Pretty damn good, man. Sipping it right out of the bottle. I want to hear from you. 646-652-4869. 000, you there?
Yeah, Ghost, I want to fuck you in the ass like a little bitch. I want to bitch ass my head. You think about that?
And you're saying that like you're badass or something. I mean, what are you?
I am badass. I will bend you over and fuck you in the ass like a Jew, motherfucker.
So you're a top man, then?
No, I'm just a horny fucking Jew. I want some ghost ass. Bend over, bitch.
You're a top man, then, huh? Do you like plugging holes?
No, I'm a gangster, motherfucker. I've been in the pen. I know how to take man.
You've been in the gangster talking like that? You sound whiter than, you know, the pasty white ass cheeks of Bill Clinton on a jog.
Yeah, fuck you, man. Fuck you, you hater. I will take you the fuck out.
You'll take me out? You sound whiter than the cottage cheese on the ass cheeks of Sally Struthers.
Man, I am an OG motherfucker. I will put this Glock to your head and pull the trigger. I will put one in your fucking head, bitch.
Oh, yeah, you sound very intimidating, man. Very intimidating. I bet you the women around here are saying, oh, my God, I mean, who's that badass? Just shut up and get over there and sit down before I choke you to death. You piece of crap. Anyway, I want to talk a little bit about, I'm going to switch subjects here. I want to talk about this American mercenary that has been found in the, you know, regions of Pakistan that are supposed to be heavily embedded with Al-Qaeda. This guy by the name of Faulkner basically took it upon himself and made it his life's mission to try to go out and hunt bin Laden. Yeah, I mean, you know, he basically told his brother and, you know, his family that, you know, he may not come back from this mission. He was going to go out and take it upon himself. He sold off everything he had to, take it upon his own personal duty to find bin Laden and kill him. He wanted to cut his head off and deliver it to America so he can be a big hero. And what I have to say about that is where are these people at now? I mean, we need more of these people. I mean, this is what America's about. You know, I mean, and according to reports, he was really close to catching bin Laden. You know, as a matter of fact, the CIA and all the other intelligence agencies are actually talking to Faulkner to see if they can actually somehow find the location of bin Laden so that somehow they can get a Predator drone or one of the military of or one of the American military to Bin Laden to assassinate him. Now, what I'm saying is that we need more American citizens as ballsy as this. You see, this guy Faulkner that went out there, that went to go hunt for Bin Laden, we need badasses like this once again. I mean, do you understand this man sold off everything that he owned and went out there in an attempt to kill this man? Death, it didn't matter. I mean, he brushed his shoulders off with death. He didn't care if he went out there and died. And now we've got, this guy almost at the brink of catching Bin Laden. Then he gets nabbed by the Pakistanis. And the Pakistanis, when they questioned him at first, and he said that he was actually out in the Pakistani region in an attempt to hunt Bin Laden, they laughed at him. They laughed at him because they didn't believe him. But lo and behold, this motivated person was very, very close to hunting Bin Laden. And what I'm saying is, where are these Americans at now? We need more Americans like this that are motivated, that got balls, that aren't a bunch of pussies, you know, that put their money where their mouth is. You know, where are these guys? You know, I pop a bottle of that guy. How about that? I'm gonna take a sip of this Dom Perignon here to that guy. Faulkner, we need more guys like you that aren't little pussy whip bastards that are wearing Ed Hardy shirts and basically looking like, you know, they just popped out of gay underground San Francisco 1979. We need badasses like you that are going to go out there, kick ass, take names, and it don't matter. You know, you ain't afraid of anything. Whatever happened to bastards that aren't afraid of anything anymore? Whatever happened to that crap? That's a lost cause, isn't it? Everybody's afraid of anything. Oh, I'm going to get the swine flu. Shut up. Good God. I'm going to tell you, that Dom P is pretty good. 646-652-4869 is the number to call here. 206, you're on the air. Hello, 206?
Shipment of Barack Obama's Afro Sheen got exploded. Did you know that?
Yeah, you stupid idiot. Give me a break. 347, you there?
Hey, Ghost. I'm calling you to let you know that Miss Kitty, will she show tits, yes or no? Can you show your tits, Ghost? Can you show me your tits? Show me them nigga bitch titties.
Yeah, Jesus Christ. I mean, is everybody hearing this? You see, I mean, listen to all the homosexual innuendo on here, for heaven's sake. I mean, these idiots are literally waxing their carrot doing this crap. I mean, you can hear them. You can hear them panting. You can hear them breathing. They're like, I'm serious. But this is America, isn't it, folks? Huh? This is a good whiff of America. That's what's so good about this program, the True Conservative Radio program. You know, when you get people calling in, you get a good smell. You get a good whiff of American people, and this is it right here. Isn't it great? Huh? Isn't this great, folks? Unbelievable. Anyway, let's keep it going, all right? 702, you there?
Yeah, I'm here. I think that we need more people like that van, and I think that right now, when they go to public schools, they teach them homosexuality. They teach them not to be self-reliant. And so that's why we have a shortage of men who can defend this country and defend our way of life, and why we have so many people who are actually, it seems, out to destroy it.
You're absolutely right, sir. And, you know, I want to thank you for calling in. These people seem like they do want to destroy this country. I mean, you take a listen to some of the people that are calling up, thinking that they're making some sort of wise jokes, some sort of wisecracks. I don't know if they're trying to impress their, you know, fat jelly-ass girlfriends because they're not giving it up, or they're trying to prove their manhood in some fashion. But if they want to go prove their manhood, why don't they just stand up and stick up for their country, stick up for the American taxpayer, stick up for the American youth, you know, the people that are getting screwed in this country. You know, and I'm going to keep saying it over and over and over again. The American taxpayer and the American youth are getting done up the anal passage with no Vaseline. And is anybody coming up saying, hey, we need to rectify this problem? No. No. You've got this Keynesian economic dominated government who believes that we need to spend ourselves into oblivion. And I don't understand Keynesian economic theory. I mean, okay, we blow ourselves into oblivion. We keep printing money until, what, it's worthless, and then what, we become the dictatorship of the proletariat? I don't get it. But inevitably, let's go back to this guy that was caught out here in Pakistan trying to hunt for bin Laden. These are the types of badasses that we need to keep producing out here in America. You know, badasses that, you know, don't care about the latest American Idol winner. Oh, yeah, look, the latest American Idol winner. Who is the latest American Idol winner? His name's Lee DeWiz? Lee DeWiz is this idiot's name. I mean, it sounds like, some sort of another way of taking a piss, you know? Hey, I got to go take a Lee DeWiz. As a matter of fact, I think that should be terminology from now on of in reference to taking pisses, all right? The next time that you have to take any kind of relief of urination, you reference your relieving of urination as Lee DeWiz, all right? I now make this decree as Ghost. From now on, if you're going to do the number one, refer to it as a Lee DeWiz. How about that, huh? I'm telling you, it's kind of hitting me here. Well, we're going to keep it going, folks. 646-652-4869 is the number to call. 313, you there?
Yeah, I'm here. All the real American heroes do videos on blacksonblondes.com. You know that, right?
Oh, you stupid idiot. Just shut up, all right? Just shut up. You sound fruity. You sound so fruity, it's disgusting. I bet you if we threw a wig on you, we wouldn't know if you were, you know, one of these people that piss standing up or sitting down, you fruit bowl. Go ahead and go take a Lee DeWiz, all right? That's what we're gonna reference. Taking a whiz now, Lee DeWiz. Go take a Lee DeWiz, you asshole. Anyway, since nobody really cares about true badasses like Faulkner out there in Pakistan trying to hunt for bin Laden on his own, utilizing his own resources and means, let's go ahead and switch up the subject, shall we? I want to talk about this stupid idiot bimbo that it keeps popping on my screen every 5 minutes like I'm supposed to feel sorry for this stupid bitch. All right? And who am I talking about? I'm talking about Sandra Bullock. That's right. I'm talking about America's sweetheart, Sandra Bullock. Are you kidding me? I mean, you're trying to sell me this as America's sweetheart? Okay, look. I'll admit it. I bought into the whole American sweetheart in relation to Sandra Bullock before she married Jesse James, all right? Jesse James. Now, when she married Jesse James, you know what that proved to me? It proved my whole theories on feminism. All the feminist commentary that I have conducted, that experiment between Sandra Bullock and Jesse James is a perfect example of what I speak of. Here you have Sandra Bullock, who's, you know, probably one of the most successful women in Hollywood. She produces movies on top of acting in movies. She's making hundreds of millions. Let me repeat that again. She's making hundreds of millions of dollars. And instead of going out and trying to, catch somebody that, you know, has some sort of, you know, couth and class and, you know, trying to, you know, get somebody of her caliber. No, you know what she goes? She goes to the, you know, to West Coast Choppers and goes and grabs this tattooed white, vanilla gorilla. She goes and gets her hooks into this vanilla gorilla and marries this goof. I mean, you know, meanwhile, look, I have nothing against Jesse James. I mean, don't get me wrong, but, I remember he was, you know, he married some porn star, all right? This is a guy who marries porn stars, for heaven's sake. So once she got married to Jesse James, I knew that's it. Sandra Bullock is no longer America's sweetheart. She's now America's used-up biker whore. And let me tell you, when this little garbage came out about Jesse James banging other bimbos, I mean, it was no surprise to me. But what makes me sick is that, you know, everybody's coddling Sandra Bullock like as if she's some sort of victim. She's not a victim. She put herself in that scenario. And this is why I bring up Sandra Bullock, because on top of her being all over the damn boob tube, people are actually looking to this woman with some sort of empathetic view. And there should be no empathy towards this stupid bimbo, you know, Sandra Bullock. She put herself in that situation. And now she doesn't know how to react to it. You know, she's in the public eye. She doesn't know how to save face. So what does she do? At the MTV Movie Awards, Sandra Bullock, America's sweetheart, decided to lay a French lesbian kiss on Scarlett Johansson. Aw, isn't that America's sweetheart right there, folks? Isn't that great? Huh? Aw, yeah, Miss Little Innocent Sandra Bullock. Huh? Oh, she's America's sweetheart. Give me a break. All right, give me a damn break. And then Jesse James, you know, what other fake-ass biker scumbag, all right? You know, when I think of a biker, I think of a guy who doesn't give a crap, you know? I think of a guy who doesn't really have a home, who runs around in his bike, you know, dirty and drinking piss and vinegar and, you know, raping teenagers and, you know, committing armed robberies and drug sales and somebody who doesn't give a crap, some outlaw, some badass, you know. I mean, that's what I think of when I think of a biker. And then you have, you know, Jesse James, you know, going on ABC, shedding those tears like some little panty-wearing schoolboy, trying to, you know, give some sort of validity on why he actually participated in philandering around. My dad beat me. My dad beat me. I mean, are you kidding me? Jesse James should have had Bombshell McGee sitting on his lap telling, you know, Sandra Bullock, you know, hey, you're just another one, you dumb broad. Or, I mean, no, no. Completely pussified Jesse James. Let me tell you, I have no respect for that piece of crap. I spit on Jesse James. If you happen to know him, email him this program, and you can tell him I said that. But Sandra Bullock, I'm sick and tired of seeing it. And this is feminism at its perfect example. A woman who is successful, who made herself hundreds of millions of dollars, and now everybody wants, we have to show her sympathy, right? We have to show her sympathy for some reason, even though this stupid bitch put herself in the situation that she's in there. I mean, she put herself in this situation, and yet she's the victim? Like, we didn't see this coming? You know, we didn't see, you know, Jesse James banging himself a couple of tattooed whore bags? I mean, give me a break. Give me a break. 646-652-4869 is the number to call here. We're going to take some more callers. 212, you there?
Hey, my God, this is Tony from New York. Hey, what you doing, Tony? I'm young, you Texas faggot, huh? You know, we're New York.
You're from New York?
Yeah, well, I'm from New York. I'm Tony, huh? Who the fuck are you?
You sound like a fruity-ass trans testicle, all right? If you're going to sound like you're from New York, why don't you sound like some greaseball Italian that's got some balls or something, you know? Like, hey, how you doing over here, man? Hey, you think you got big bulls, eh? Hey, I got a couple of broads over here. One, two, or three of these broads over here, eh? And if you talk the garbage to me, I'll stomp your teeth down your throat. Now, that's how you're supposed to act in New York, you know, because, you know, I don't really like New Yorkers, and I've said it time and time again. You know, I went to New York a few times. As soon as I stepped off the plane, it smelled like a combination of piss, trash, and shit, and I mean, I don't even want to talk about it. And then everybody seemed like they were taking it in the ass out there in New York. You know, you couldn't even get a kind soul out there. You couldn't even get, you know, anybody with a smile on their face. I mean, it's disgusting. I don't want to talk about New York. Anyway, 450, you there?
Yeah, my name is Danny Grove, and I love interracial porn. The black cop turns.
Shut up. You sound like a stupid little fruit bowl that's barely got peach fuzz on your nards. All right, 570, you there?
Hey, Ghost, I just wanted to ask you about what do you think about Howard Stern's penis?
Yeah, here we go again. Howard Stern. You know, what really makes me sick, and before I get off on this tirade, I'm going to take a big chug of this dumb pee. Hold on. You know, we got ourselves another Howard Stern-ass clown. We got a bunch of prank callers. You know, this is kind of why I don't do the program that often. I don't do the program that often because, let me tell you, folks, I know that I'm getting ripped off by Glenn Beck and Savage and Levin and all these idiots that are basically regurgitating the commentary that I convey on this broadcast like several days after I conduct it. But what's really unfortunate is that not only am I getting ripped off by them, but I have prognosticated events that have come to pass. And you can look back in the archive if you don't believe me. And still, I have yet to penetrate the simple minds in this country, the simple minds that listen to me on a consistent basis. I mean, this is why I don't do that many broadcasts. I don't understand what it's going to take to penetrate the simple-ass minds. I mean, what is it going to take, for heaven's sake? I mean, these people are so simple out here, folks. They don't give a crap. They don't give a crap about themselves. They don't give a crap about their country. And, you know, folks, this is why I get so damn angry. This is why I get so goddamn emotional when I get on this broadcast, folks, because I'm trying to penetrate the simple minds. 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 That's what I'm attempting to do. Penetrate the simple minds. Say it with me, folks. If you're listening to me, say it with me. Penetrate the simple minds. Penetrate the simple minds. Penetrate the simple minds. Penetrate the simple mind.
Penetrate all the simple minds. They adore what a fall out of the
sky. Penetrate the simple mind. Penetrate the simple mind. Come on. Come on and penetrate the simple mind.
Penetrate the simple mind.
Penetrate the simple mind. Are you listening? Penetrate the simple mind. Trying to do, you idiots. I mean, don't you understand the passion
and the fury that I convey on this broadcast, I'm trying to penetrate the simple minds and spark synapses in the brains in hopes of getting you to be politically, socially, and economically active. But I don't know if you're listening. I don't know if anybody's listening. And this is why I don't do that many broadcasts, folks. Anyway, if you want to be here in the live broadcast with us, folks, the best way to figure out when I'm going to conduct one of these live broadcasts is to follow me on Twitter. And, of course, the Twitter name is Ghost Politics. All one word, no underscores, Ghost Politics. Yeah, let me tell you, that's some pretty good Dom P, folks. Pretty damn good Dom P. Anyway, folks, I'm getting a little tipsy here. But we're going to continue going. We got 20 minutes left in the program, and I hope that we can get some individuals within the broadcast that can actually, say something of any kind of substance-filled value. So let's go ahead and go to the phone. 646-652-4869 is the number to call here. 702, you there?
You there, Ghost?
Yeah, what's going on?
Oh, this is Ranger.
How you doing, Ranger?
I'm doing pretty good. I've been doing BTR for a couple years now. And I started out with Pat Dollard, black conservative. And I was the unfortunate victim to be Bill Wagner's co-host for a few months. And I've heard a lot about your show over the last, year or so. And I appreciate your passion, but I think you give these dipshit libtards just too much lip service. I just hang up on their ass and go on to the next caller because they love getting, they love getting a rise out of you and getting you to respond and getting all pissed off, and that's why they keep calling back. But if you just hang up as soon as you hear the bullshit come out of their mouth and you know what they are, just shit can them. That's all I got to say. I'm not trying to tell you how to run the show, but I'm just saying if it was my show, that's what I'd do. But at any rate, I wanted to tell you a really funny story that's true. This was an NPR radio host that was interviewing a Marine general. And I don't remember the general's name, and I don't remember the base, but the Marine Corps doesn't have a whole lot of bases anyway. But the gist of it was this Marine Corps general and his base, they were going to sponsor a Boy Scout troop, right? And this NPR interviewer was asking the Marine general, like, well, what things are you going to teach these Boy Scouts? And he said, well, we're going to teach them, like, rappelling and archery or canoeing and stuff like that. And then he said, like basic firearms or whatever. And she's like, oh, my God, isn't that really dangerous? And that's just like being so irresponsible and this and that. And the general said, well, no, because they're going to get intensive, firearms training before they even touch a gun. And then they'll have instructors there at the range, and she's like, well, aren't you equipping them to be natural-born killers or whatever, something like that, equipping them to be killers? And the general responded back. He says, you're equipped to be a prostitute, but you're not one, are you? And then she hung up and told him dead.
Inevitably, you're cutting in and out, so I didn't get the last part of it, but I want to thank you for your call, sir. I want to thank you for your kind words, but I don't think I give these liberals that much lip service. Inevitably, as much as these liberals may hate me and try to agitate me and get a rise out of me, they're listening. They're listening, and they understand what I am conveying on this broadcast. They're listening and witnessing the prognostications that I have conveyed within the past several years. And these individuals know exactly what I'm talking about. They know that I'm as serious as a damn heart attack. So as long as they continue to listen and continue to follow the program, I mean, they can continue to call as much as they want to. I don't really appreciate all the fruit bowl, little fruity-ass, dumbass prank calls and all this other nonsense, but inevitably, a lot of these people that are listening that are doing this are young, and those are the individuals that need to be penetrated through their simple minds. Those are the individuals that have to get up and start doing something instead of sitting on their fat jelly asses. And like I've suggested, the least they could do is get a damn blog. The least they could do is go out and get a website. The least they can do is go out and do something in that fashion to convey ideas in hopes of persuading those that are sitting on the sidelines looking from within. And this is why I conduct this broadcast on a consistent basis, folks. But anyway, folks, I'm a little bushed. I'm a little tired. I mean, we got about 15 minutes left in the program, folks, but I'm a little tired, for heaven's sake. I'm sweating like a damn sweat dog here. But once again, folks, if you want to be the first one to figure out when I'm going to conduct a live broadcast, please add me to your following on Twitter. Ghost Politics is the name to follow. And secondly, folks, we're trying to get people interviewed here. There's been a couple of people that wanted to be interviewed on the True Conservative Radio program, but unfortunately, because of whatever content that's being broadcasted from this broadcast is making people a little apprehensive. So, you know, if you, as the True Conservative listeners, if you can go out and make some emails to influential people who you would like to listen interviewed on this broadcast, go ahead and get the word out, if you will. Because everybody's a little apprehensive about, conducting an interview on this broadcast. So I need your help. Go out there and try to get some of these famous folks, specifically in the political realm, to be interviewed by Ghost. And let me tell you, I'm not going to sit here and, you know, throw any little pity-pat punches either. But there needs to be a demand behind it. So in my plea to all those that are listening, please email all these talking heads and let them know about the True Conservative Radio program. Email the New York Times, email CNBC, CNN, Fox News, email everybody you can and let everybody know about the True Conservative Radio program so we can finally get some damn idiots to interview on here so I can make them look lower than a leprechaun's nutsack. Anyway, folks, I know that I haven't been keeping up with the blog, but I will be updating it as soon as I can, so please add that to your favorites, ghostpolitics.blogspot.com. And, of course, folks, follow me on Twitter. It's the quickest way to figure out when I'm going to conduct these broadcasts. Ghost Politics is the name to follow. Anyway, folks, I'm going to cut this show short. I'm going to finish my Dom P and maybe go out in the back here, smoke my little Opus X cigar. And I want to say thank you to everybody who is listening to me live on the broadcast. Whether you like me, whether you hate me, spread the word, all right? Spread the word about the True Conservative Radio program. Email these broadcasts. If you hear me insulting somebody that you like or don't like, email them the broadcast. What are you doing? You got these tools at your fingertips. But it takes you to actually implement it so it can go in its organic form. Anyway, folks, I want to thank you very much for tuning in with me. Once again, the official website of the True Conservative Radio program is blogtalkradio.com/ghost. Anyway, I'm out of here. I'm cutting the show 10 minutes short. I will be on the Pal Talk Network if anybody wants to, you know, have an after chat with me here in about 5 or 10 minutes. So if you want to do that, be on the lookout for OG_Ghost. OG_Ghost is my paltalk.com name. I'll be out there chatting in about 10 or 15 minutes. So if you want to have an after chat session with yours truly, I will be on there. Thank you once again for tuning in with me. I may or may not have a show tomorrow, but you know what'll persuade me to have more shows if I start seeing people giving a crap about the show. If I start seeing more YouTube videos and more comments, you know, I mean, I just want to see a response, folks. I don't think that anybody's listening. So I would appreciate some more YouTube videos promoting the True Conservative Radio program. You know what I'm talking about? Anyway, thank you very much for tuning in with me. Ghost Politics is the name to follow on Twitter. Please follow it, all right? And tell everybody you know to follow it, too. Thank you very much for tuning in with me. Long live the true conservative movement. Death to feminism and death to the welfare state.
A Napa guy knows the only way you'd give a freshly minted driver a brand new car is if he promises to never drive it. Instead, let him grind the gears and knock over the neighbor's mailbox in something a little more suited to his skill level. And with over 400,000 parts and a little Napa know-how, he can safely drive something that's nearly as old as he is. It's not perfect, but it's perfect for him. That's Napa know-how.